Hallelujah. Acts the fourth chapter, verse 10 through 13 and verse 18. That'll be the four key scriptures. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God loves us all.
Yes, He
does. Love all His children. Amen. And we see the table and the decoration look pretty fine. Amen. Amen. I came in, I ready to fight because I ain't know who had been up in here. But I knew it had to be sitting and dad doing, because it's kind of like more of their taste kind of. I told Bay, I said, they had to put it in here. I said, wasn't in here earlier. Amen. So we thank you all. Amen. Beautiful. Tableside, beautiful. Amen. So if y'all want to skip over there, I guess y'all can skip over there. Amen. I believe that's the reason why they brought it. We got a call from some who said they won't be able to make it. They ain't going to miss all that. That's what you get. Amen. Acts the fourth chapter, verse 10 through 13. Yes, Lord. When you had to, please say amen.
Amen.
Be it known unto you all and to all the people of Israel that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom ye crucified, whom God raised from the dead, even by him do this man stand here by you whole. This is a stone which was set at naught of you builders, which has become the head of the corner. Neither is there salvation in any other name. For there is no other name under heaven given among men, whereby we must be saved. Now when they saw the boldness of Peter and John, and perceived that they were uneducated and ignorant men, they marveled and took knowledge of them that they had been with Jesus. Look at verse 18. And they called them and commanded them not to speak at all, nor teach in the name of Jesus. Saints of God, I want to deal with tonight is in the name of Jesus, that wonderful name of Jesus. It's in the name of Jesus, that wonderful name of Jesus. It's in the name of Jesus, that wonderful name of Jesus. Saints of God, we pray in the name of Jesus. We come out through the name of Jesus. Healing is manifested through the name of Jesus. Restoration is released through the name of Jesus. Revival is released in the house of God through the name of Jesus. All we praise God through that wonderful name of Jesus. We magnify God through that wonderful name of Jesus. We send up praise in the sanctuary through that wonderful name of Jesus. We worship God through that wonderful name of Jesus. We serve God through that wonderful name of Jesus. Deliverance happened in our midst, saints of God, through that wonderful name of Jesus. It's through the name of Jesus that you're going to come out, saints of God. It's through the name of Jesus that that situation is going to be turned around. It's through the name of Jesus. We do everything through the name of Jesus. We pray through the name of Jesus. We come to the Father through the name of Jesus, through that wonderful name of Jesus. You can say any name you want to, and you won't get no backlash. You can say any other name you want to, and you won't get no persecution. You can bring up Buddha, and won't nobody say nothing. You can bring up Muhammad and won't nobody say nothing. You can bring up Confucius and won't nobody say nothing. But if that's when you say the name of Jesus. All the enemy hate when you say the name of Jesus. Demons begin to tremble when you say the name of Jesus. You can go in the courthouse. You can bring up witchcraft. You can bring up Buddhism, Hinduism. But they don't got no problem with it. But as soon as you say something about Jesus, demons begin to tremble. When you start bringing up the name of Jesus, that's when you get prosecution. Every other name that you brought up around your family, they didn't have no problem with you. But as soon as you start saying something about the name of Jesus, you start getting prosecuted when you said something about the name of Jesus. All your life was going real smooth until you came to God and you start saying something about the name of Jesus. All hell broke loose when you said something about the name of Jesus, because the enemy knows that in the name of Jesus, there is deliverance. In the name of Jesus, there is sanctification. In the name of Jesus, there is salvation. In the name of Jesus, there is healing and turnaround. Do you hear me? The enemy knows about the name of Jesus. And saints of God, tonight, I just want to speak to you about that wonderful name of Jesus. It's going to be done in the name of Jesus. How many names have you tried, saints of God? Do you hear me? Before you begin to try the name of Jesus. Oh, let me tell you something. Let me just give you a personal testimony, because I tried Bumpy Face at first, and that didn't work. I tried Newport Cigarettes. Guess what? That didn't work. See, what kind of name have you tried? I tried to get a car, a house, and a yard. Guess what? That did not work. A job, it did not work. But when I came to Jesus, that name that's above every name, when I came to that wonderful name of Jesus, things began to turn and deliverance began to happen and yokes began to be destroyed and burdens began to be lifted. Do you hear me? When I came and submitted myself upon the name of Jesus, and saints of God, I want to ask you tonight, what name are you trying?
My God.
To use to be delivered. What name are you trying? Is it Kavassier? Do you hear me? Is it a little Mary Jane? Do you hear me? What kind of drug are you trying to use to try to bring about some kind of joy and happiness on the inside of your life? Let me tell you something. It's only upon one name, and that's the name of Jesus. Marvin ain't going to do it. Shaquille ain't going to do it. Shaquita ain't going to do it. Run ain't going to do it. You got to get up under the name of Jesus. How many names have you been trying, saints of God? All through the years, we've been trying all kinds of names. Do you hear me? And just be truthful about it. But ain't no name brought no peace. Ain't no name brought no comfort. Ain't no name brought no console to my heart like the name of Jesus. Ain't no name brought no peace, do you hear me? Ain't no restoration to my soul, nothing but the name of Jesus. Ain't no name came, saints of God, and brought about deliverance to my spirit, nothing but the name of Jesus. It's in that name that it's going to be done. What name have we been trying to use, saints of God? Because a lot of us have been trying to use different names. And different names ain't going to get it done. It's going to be done through the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Hmm. Jesus, the Son of God, the Lamb of God, your great high priest, your advocate, the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. I'm talking about Jesus. I'm talking about the Lamb of God. Do you hear me, saints of God? I'm talking about the offspring and root of Jesse. I'm talking about Jesus. I'm talking about your Savior. I'm talking about the wonderful counselor. I'm talking about the mighty God. I'm talking about the Prince of Peace. I'm talking about rulers of rulers and Lord of lords and King of kings. I'm talking about Jesus. I'm talking about that wonderful name of Jesus. What do Jesus mean? Because we pray in that name. We worship in that name. What do we mean when we say Jesus? Now, saints of God, let me give you an understanding now, because his original name in Hebrew is Yeshua. Some say Yahshua. Now, let's not be dogmatic, because I don't ever want us to be dogmatic up in here. Because some people spell it Y-E-S-H-U-A, Yeshua. They say that's the right way to pronounce it. But then some people say Yahshua, Y-A-H-U-S-H-U-A, Yahshua. They said that's the right way to pronounce it. I'm talking about in Hebrew, his original name. When you get to English, we call it Jesus. Now, let me tell you something. A long time ago now, when I first started hearing about the name Yahshua, now I used to say Yahshua. And I asked God one day, I said, God, I said, if we use the name Yahshua, I said, will you still respond? That same night, I went to sleep. No lie. Right here before God. I'm in his house. I went to sleep. And in a dream, me and some people were sitting around the table talking. And we started hearing footsteps. Like the whole room was shaking. Like the whole room, it was like it was an earthquake. And when we looked up, we looked at the door. And in came in two big creatures that had pig faces. They had heads that were so huge. And they was walking in the room, stomping. And all of us ran and flew up on the table. And when I got up on the table, something said, tell them to get out in the name of Yahshua. And I said, in the name of Yahshua, get out of here. And man, they, how quick they ran. Don't even seem like they can move that fast. But when I said Yahshua, they flew out the room. And I woke up out the dream. And God was showing me near. God said, if you use that name, Yahshua, he said, demons will flee. Demons will run. Do you hear me? But you have people that will say, you're wrong for saying Yahshua. It should be Yeshua. Let's not be dogmatic. If we hear somebody here say Yeshua, we know they're talking about the Son of God. Let's not put people in hell because they're not pronouncing it the way you think they should pronounce it. Or they say Yahshua. Don't put nobody in hell, because God knows all things. Do you hear me? Yah, yay. God still know who you're talking about. Yeah. Do you hear me? If you say Jesus. Because you got people that will tell you his name wasn't Jesus. There wasn't no J's in the Hebrew alphabet. Uh-huh. The J didn't come along until about 800 years later. But we don't speak Hebrew. We speak English. Yeah. The Mexicans will say Jesus. But Americans will say Jesus. Do you hear me? Yeah. But God know who you're talking about. He know who you're talking about. The Son of God.
Yes.
Demons still tremble when you say Jesus, just like you say Yeshua or Yahshua. Do you hear me? They still will flee. Sickness will still dissipate when you call on the name of Jesus or Yeshua or Yahshua. Do you hear me?
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeshua. I want you to know who you're crying out to. Mm-hmm. Yeshua. We pray to the Father in that name. Yeshua, Jesus' name means Yahweh is salvation, or Jehovah is salvation. His name reflects right back to his Father. Do you hear me say to God? When you say Jesus, you're really saying Jehovah, the Father, is my salvation. Because his name reflects back to the Father. Do you hear me? That's how come I keep telling you that you can't separate Jesus from the Father. You say, I'm serving three different gods. No, you ain't. You serving one God in three persons. Their nature is the same. Do you hear me? It's in the name of Jesus. He said, my Father is salvation.
Yes.
Everybody, we got Jesus-only people now. Mm-hmm. The only thing we do is talk about Jesus. Mm-hmm. And if somebody bring up the Father, we say that they wrong. Uh-huh. But Jesus said, I am the door. Uh-huh. Do you hear me? If you come to that door, you don't stop at the door. You go past the door and come in the room. Do you hear me? If you want to get to the Father, you got to go through Jesus.
Yes.
He was beat for you. Yes. He was wounded for your transgressions. He was bruised for your iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed.
Yes.
He recounseled us back to the Father. He didn't come to take the Father's place. He came to recounsel us back to the Father.
Yes.
But we have people who just say Jesus, and you say the Father, they try to kick the Father out of the equation. But you can't kick out Jehovah.
Yes.
You can't kick out Yahweh. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes should not perish but have everlasting life. You just can't talk about Jesus and don't talk about the Father.
Yes.
We pray to the Father in Jesus' name. His name reflect back to his Father. Jesus' name don't point to him. He point back to the Father. He said, my Father is salvation. So when we pray in the name of Jesus, we understand that in the name of Jesus, there is salvation. What is salvation? Salvation means to be rescued from danger. And saints of God, we know that we need to be saved.
Yeah.
And I know that it's not popular now in the house of God to talk about hell. But the first thing you need to understand is that when you got saved from hell.
Yeah.
He said, my Father is salvation.
Yeah.
He said, it was my Father who saved you from hell.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Salvation means delivered.
Yeah.
When we say that we saved, mm-hmm. we don't even know what we're talking about. But when you say that you're saved, and you get up and get that testimony, I thank God that I'm saved. Holy Ghost filled, fire baptized, speaking in tongues, and spirit get utterance. You need to understand what you're saying. Because when you say that you're saved, you say, God, pour my feet out of the miry clay. Do you hear me? When you say that you're saved, you say, God, deliver me from darkness, and God, deliver me from going to a burning hell. Do you hear me? When you say that you're saved, you say, God, snatch my feet out of a devil's pit, that the devil had dug for me. Do you hear me? You say, I'm saved. My God is salvation. He rescued me. He delivered me from a life of drugs. Delivered me from a life of sin. Delivered me from a life of confusion. Delivered me from a life of depression. My God is salvation. Do you hear me? But you only can get it when you go through the name of Jesus. My God is deliverance. Whatever you need deliverance from, you're going to get it in the name of Jesus. I told you it's going to be done in the name of Jesus. If you're going to be delivered, you're going to be delivered through the name of Jesus. If that burden going to be lifted, it's going to be through the name of Jesus. If that yoke going to be destroyed, it's going to be through the name of Jesus. If you're going to get some turnaround in your life, it's going to be through the name of Jesus. If you're going to get some restoration, it's going to be through the name of Jesus. Why? Because God is a deliverer.
Oh, yes.
And his name said, my God is a rescuer. He rescues. His name said, my God is a deliverer. Not only do salvation mean deliverance, but it means preservation. Not only do I need God to save me, but I need God to preserve me. God, I need you to keep me, oh God. Do you hear me say to God? How many need God to keep them? You need God to be your preservation. God, I need you to sustain me, oh God. I don't got the strength on my own. I need you to preserve me, oh God. He said, my God is preservation. He said, my God is salvation. When a person say I'm saved, they say I'm healed. Not just physically, but mentally, emotionally. That's what come John say, beloved. He said, I wish that you prosper and be in health, even as your soul prosper. He said, now, he said, listen, your soul needs to prosper. Some of our soul needs to prosper. Our emotions need to prosper. We're not prospering on the inside. You may not got no sickness on the outside, but you got some sickness down on the inside. And that's what constantly driving you to the alcohol and to those drugs and to different relationships that you know that's harmful for you. You know why? Because you're not whole on the inside. But you got to make that declaration that I'm saved. And since I'm saved, that means that I'm whole. That means that I'm walking in a peace of God and walking in a joy. God, in his presence is fullness of joy. Do you hear me say to God, he has given me his peace, which surpasses all understanding. You know why? Because I'm saved.
Yes, because I'm saved.
And say to God, you got to tell the devil, I'm saved.
I'm
Do you
saved.
Hear me?
Yes,
I'm healed.
Yes.
Listen, I don't care what I feel, I'm healed. I won't listen to Joshua live by faith. I'm healed of what they did. I'm healed of what they said. I'm healed of the abuse. Do you hear me say to God? Because I'm saved. When you say, you saying I'm healed on the inside. You got to stop walking around and you still wounded. You got to make the declaration that I'm healed. I'm healed in my emotions. I'm healed in my mind. Do you hear me? Because I'm saved. I'm going through the name of Jesus and my God is salvation. My God is healing.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Redemption. My God is redemption. My God is sanctification. When you come through Jesus, he points you back to the Father.
Come on.
He's pointing, looking at the Father. When you come through him, you're going to get to the Father.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
But I'm saved.
I'm saved.
Oh, my God. I want to speak to you about the salvation package. Because a lot of you don't know what's wrapped up in the salvation package. That when you get saved, peace is wrapped up in the salvation package.
Yes, it is.
You have not got your peace yet, but it's wrapped up in the salvation package. Now, let me tell you something. Dad and mom bought their table in here, and they put some candy on the table, but it's wrapped up right now. But if you want to know what's up under that sheet, you got to go up there and you got to remove the package out from it. Do you hear me? In order for you to know what's inside your salvation package, you got to open up the Word of God. Do you hear me? You got to remove the lid off the Word of God. You got to open the Word of God so you can see what is the promises of God that's inside this salvation package. But peace.
Yes,
it's inside this salvation package.
Yes,
that you don't have to let your mind be confused. You don't have to let your mind be worried. But peace will surpass it. All understanding is inside this salvation package. Do you hear me? All joy, unspeakable joy. In the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy. His joy gives me strength. Joy, gladness, cheerfulness is inside this salvation package. Thank you, God. Do you hear me? You need to go through another year. You need to go through another day or another month without walking in the joy of God, because the joy of God is wrapped up in the salvation package.
Yes, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Say, it's wrapped up in the salvation package. And what I'm finna get ready to do, I'm finna get ready to go home, and I'm finna get ready to take the cover off the salvation package. Do you hear me? I'm finna see what God had placed down on the inside of it. I'm finna see the promise of God, because it's wrapped up in the salvation package. My peace, my joy, my healing. He was wounded for my transgression and bruised for my iniquities. The chastisement of my peace was upon him, and by his stripe I am healed. Do you hear me? My healing is wrapped up in the salvation package.
Yeah.
You just got to get into the Word of God, and you got to declare that in the atmosphere. Do you hear me? I believe, therefore I spoke, is what Paul said. I believe that I'm healed. I don't care what I'm feeling, but it's wrapped up in the salvation package. God said you're already healed. God said you're already delivered. God said you're already set free. God said I've already turned that situation around. God said I've already brought restoration. God said I've already given you strength. For those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk in faith. It's wrapped up in the salvation package.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
I come into the house of God so I can hear what's in the salvation package. Because you got to go claim your benefits. Do you hear me say to God? My purpose is wrapped up in a salvation package. I didn't know what I was called to do at first, but I found out my purpose when I got saved, and it was wrapped up in the salvation package. I didn't even know I was called to preach. I didn't even know I was called to teach God's word. I didn't even know I was called to lead God's people. But I messed around, and the devil let me get into the salvation package. And when I got into the salvation package, I began to find out my purpose. I began to find out my destiny. Do you hear me say to God? I began to find out that I'm already accepted in the Lord. But I'm the head out the tail above and I believe. And blessed am I going in, and blessed am I coming out when I get into the salvation package. Do you hear me say to God?
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory. The
enemy fights you.
Yes, Lord.
To open up the salvation package. He wants you to keep the ribbon tied on it. He don't want you to pop the top off of it. Do you hear me? But then I got to pop the top. Because I got to see what's inside of this salvation package. Do you hear me? I can't keep going on walking in depression. I can't keep going on walking in fear. I can't keep going on walking in uncertainty. I got to open up the salvation package and see the promises of God. The promises of God, they are yea and amen. Do you hear me? God is not a man that he shall lie, nor the son of man that he shall repent. If God says, I'm giving you joy, guess what? He's giving you joy. If God says, I'm giving you peace, we surpass all understanding, guess what? God is giving you peace. If God says, I'm giving you strength, guess what? He's giving you strength. I got to look inside of the salvation package.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
He said,
thank you, Jesus.
My Father got the salvation package.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
He said, just come through me. And he said, you can get the salvation package.
Yes, Lord.
But it's going to be done through the name of Jesus.
Through the name of Jesus.
We got to understand what we say, the name of Jesus. Jesus said, I am the way.
The way.
The truth and the life. He said, no man come to the Father but through me.
Yes,
that's John, the 14th chapter.
Yes,
the 6th verse, you can read it in your own time. Jesus said unto him, I am the way to the Father. I am the truth to the Father. I am the life. No man coming unto the Father but by me. You can't come through Muhammad. Jesus said, you won't get there. You can't come through Confucius. Jesus said, you won't get there. He said, you got to come through Jesus. Ain't no prophet walked the earth and said, you got to come through them. But Jesus was so bold. Jesus stepped out on nothing. Do you hear me? Jesus came and got into a body and started casting out devils and telling devils to shut up and get out of people's body. I'm talking about Jesus who was walking the streets of Galilee and was healing the sick. Do you hear me? And raising the dead. I'm talking about Jesus who was cleaning the lepers. Do you hear me? Saints of God. I'm talking about Jesus who walked to the tomb and told Lazarus, come forth right now. I'm talking about that same Jesus. I'm talking about Jesus who walked on water. I'm talking about Jesus. I'm talking about Jesus Christ. I'm talking about the anointed. I'm talking about the all-powerful one. I'm talking about Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
No man coming to the Father.
Yeah.
He said, but through me. Jesus said, you got to come through my name. Do you hear me, saints of God? Oh, my God. He said, I am the way. I am the truth.
He
said, I am the life. Life means Zoe life, which is the God kind of life. Some of us need to live the God kind of life. We live in bio, but we ain't living Zoe. Bio life is life that's in the natural. That's living bio life. Bio life said, I was born here. This is where I worked at. This is my family. And this is the year that I die. That's bio. But when you step over into the kind of life that Jesus was talking about, that's the Zoe kind of life. That's the God kind of life. Some of us need to be able to live the God kind of life. You can't tap into the joy of God because you have not started living the God kind of life.
Hallelujah.
You can't tap into the peace of God because you have not started living the God kind of life. Do you hear me? It's in his presence.
In his presence. Amen. My God.
There is no joy outside of the presence of God. There is no peace outside of the presence of God. There is no love outside of the presence of God. I started learning about love when I came to God through Jesus. And God started showing me what love was. And I thought love was just about sex. It's what I thought love was. I said, that's what love is.
My God.
But God started showing me they don't got nothing to do with love. How you going to understand love and you haven't came to God? When the Bible said God is love.
He is love.
If you want to understand love, come to God. And then God will tell you, that's not love from him beating you across your head. God said, that ain't love like I'm taking your money and running off and coming home 3 months later. God said, that's not love. But God said, you got to come to me to understand my love. You got to tap into the Zoe life.
The Zoe life. Yes.
Jesus said, I am the way.
I am the way.
The truth and the life.
Yes.
He was the only prophet that said, nobody can come to the Father except through me.
Except
he said, if you don't come through me, he said, you won't get to the Father. Now, I know there's a lot of people who got a problem with that. They say, oh, you just can't say that's the only way. But I didn't say that was the only way. Jesus said that he was the only way. Do you hear me? But I am the way. Truth and the life. Go to John chapter 16. Let me show you about the name of Jesus. We're talking about the name of Jesus. My God. John chapter 16, verse 23. We're talking about the name of Jesus. Why we use that name? All that name is above every name. My God, my God. Demons begin to tremble when you call their name. They begin to flee when you say their name. You can say Marvin and they won't go nowhere. You can say Big Bone Brenda and they won't move. Do you hear me? You can call all kinds of names and the devil won't move out your house. You can light incense. Do you hear me? You can put a paint on your face and dance around the room and they still won't move. But as soon as you say Jesus, when you say that name, they begin to tremble. Do you hear me? The Bible said you believe there is one God. The Bible said you do well. Even the demons believe and tremble.
Yes.
They're in your house. But if you just use Jesus' name, they'll begin to tremble.
Oh,
yeah. They're not trembling at your triceps and biceps and your little pills you got over beside you. But as soon as you say Jesus, they begin to run. When you cry out Jesus, it can be chaotic in atmosphere in your house. But as soon as you say Jesus, everything in the atmosphere comes to a calm. Do you hear me? Oh, there's something about the name of Jesus. Do you hear me? The demons begin to tremble. It's something about the name of Jesus. When the enemy back is broken, when you say the name of Jesus, all of you get delivered through the name of Jesus. You get set free through the name of Jesus. Your body will get healed through the name of Jesus. Oh, somebody just say Jesus, 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 my way maker, my turnaround. Do you hear me? My shield, my buckle, my strong tower. I'm talking about Jesus.
My God.
You're coming out tonight.
Oh, Jesus.
Through the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
It's all about Jesus. Yes. What else do we do in Jesus? Look at John chapter 16. I told you to go to verse 23. Yes. This is Jesus speaking out. Because where we see red written, we know who is that.
That's Jesus.
Yes. Okay, in that day, this is Jesus speaking, you should ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, whatsoever you ask the Father in my name, in whose name? In my name, he will give it to you. He said, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he said, my Father will do it. We can't go ask the Father something in our own name. He said, you got to come through the name of Jesus. He said, if you ask him in my name, he said, my Father will do it. Hereunto, he said, hereunto you have asked nothing in my name, because he wasn't crucified yet. He hadn't rose from the dead yet. He said, ask and you shall receive, that your joy may be full. These things have I spoken unto you in Proverbs, but the time cometh when I shall no more speak unto you in Proverbs, but I shall show you plainly of the Father. And that day you shall ask in my name. In whose name? In my name. And I say not unto you that I will pray the Father for you. Listen, he said, you pray to the Father, he said, pray in my name. He said, come in my name. Do you hear me, saints of God? He said, you got to come to the Father through my name.
Yes, yes.
Can I show you something? I go to John chapter 14, the same book, 14, verse 13 and 14. He said, whatsoever you should ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. Yes. If you should ask anything in who?
My name.
In my name. He said, I will do it. He's telling you to ask the Father in his name. You have to come through that name. Go to Matthew chapter 18. He's showing you something now. Matthew chapter 18. I'm taking you to a certain place now. You know, Pastor don't have you going unless it's a reason. Matthew chapter 18 and verse 20.
Hallelujah.
He said, for with two or three are gathered what? Together in my name. There I am in the midst. When we come into the house of God and we gather together in the name of Jesus, he said, I'm going to be right in the midst of y'all. But we gather in his name. Thank you, Jesus. Go to Luke chapter 10. Let me show you something now. I want to show you the authority of the name of Jesus. And I'm going to be ready to close after a while, but I want to give you something. Look at Luke chapter 10, verse 17 through 20. I want you to get there. Yes, Lord, you there?
Amen.
Now, these are the 70 that Jesus sent out now to preach. And the 70 returned again with joy, saying, Lord, even the devils are subject to us in who?
In your name.
Through your name. Ain't no demon subject to you in nobody else's name. Nothing but the name of Jesus.
Yes.
They said, Lord, when we said Jesus, demons begin to come out of people. They said, when we say Jesus, people's bodies begin to get healed. They said, listen, they are subject to us in your name. And Jesus said, oh, you think there's something? He said, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. Mm-hmm. He said, Satan got crazy. And he said, when the Father hit him, he said, Satan fell like lightning from heaven. Uh-huh. Lightning strike quick. Do you hear me?
Yes.
He said, that's how quick it was over. He said, God hit him one time and boom, he was down. Do you hear me? He said, so it ain't no great things if his little demons up on him is running because of my name. Look at verse 19. He said, behold, I give unto you what?
Power.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
now, I'm not talking about dunamis power. Because that's Holy Ghost power.
Come on.
When you get filled with the Holy Ghost, that's dunamis power.
Yes.
That's dynamite power.
Come on.
When the Holy Ghost gets to moving, there's an explosion.
Yes.
My wife put on Facebook last Sunday before God got to moving in here. She said, get ready for a boom, boom, boom. You know why? She said, boom, boom, boom in the spirit, in the glory. You know why? Because when the Holy Ghost moves, there's explosion.
Come on.
It's dunamis when we get the word dynamite.
Come on.
When the Holy Ghost show up, he brings dynamite power.
Hallelujah.
You be sitting up 1 minute, and the next thing you know, people laid out all the front, and walk out, boom. Dynamite power, do you hear me? But Jesus don't bring dunamis. He bring exousia. That's why he said, I have given you the authority.
Uh-huh.
Some translations have power, some have authority. But I want to speak to you about authority. Exousia.
Uh-huh.
Jesus told him, he said, listen, I give y'all weight.
Yes. My God.
When a person got a weight in the natural arena, if a dope boy got weight, you see, he got a whole lot of dope.
Uh-huh.
You see, that boy move weight.
Uh-huh.
But Jesus said, I'm giving you weight in the spirit.
My God.
He said that when you war in the spirit, he said, when the devil run up on you, you're going to have a lot of weight. Do you hear me? He said, I give you exousia.
Uh-huh.
He said, I give you authority. He said, I give you my weight.
My weight.
Influence. I mean influence.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus, I give you influence.
Yes.
You letting the devil scare you in your house when Jesus have already give you the influence and given you weight to kick him out of your life. Do you hear me?
Yes.
He said, I give you influence.
Uh-huh.
He said, I'm going to give you some influence in the spirit you're in. Do you hear me?
Yes.
Because we got some influence. Authority means moral authority. The devil ain't afraid of you.
Mm-mm.
If you don't got no moral authority.
Come on.
He don't care about you having a big house and you being a mayor. Or you living in the governor's mansion. He don't care nothing about that. He don't care about you being a judge. You got a robe on. He don't care nothing about you being a police officer. But what he do care about is that you got some authority from Jesus. Because when you got some authority from Jesus, you can move stuff in the spirit.
Yes.
Do you hear me say to God? He said, I've given you the authority. Moral authority, conferred power, it's the right of attorney.
Uh-huh.
We know that the right of attorney is when somebody else let you use their name.
Yes.
You go in their own power. Jesus said, I've given you exousia, I've given you the right of attorney to act in my name.
My God.
So when you tell the devil to get out your house, don't you sit up and be scared to myself, I don't supposed to say that. No, he said, I've given you the authority.
Yes.
I've given you the right of attorney. He said, you can use my name.
Yes.
He said, if you use my name, he said, I'm going to back it up. You say, how are you going to back it up? I'm going to show you because God got police officers in the spirit.
Yes.
Who are they? They are the angels of God.
Yes.
Because the angels of the Lord, they camp around those who fear him.
Yes.
And you start telling the devil to get out.
Yes.
Angels show up with flaming swords
yes.
and begin to chase demons out the road. Do you hear me? All you got to understand that you got exousia.
Yes.
You got to understand that you got weight in the spirit.
Yes.
And you got influence. Do you hear me? That you got exousia of power.
My God. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Devil trying to whisper and tell you, you can't tell me to get out, and you don't have no right to say that, and you don't have no right to do that. But devil, he gave me exousia.
Uh-huh.
He gave me the right of an attorney. Do you hear me? Jesus said, occupy till I come. Now I told you that exousia and dunamis is different.
Uh-huh.
Let me show you what dunamis is. Dunamis is raw power, Holy Ghost power.
Uh-huh.
A police officer, yeah, that's a good example. A police officer. Authority is his badge.
Uh-huh.
That's his exousia.
Uh-huh.
When he show up and he tell you, we got a warrant for your arrest, turn around, put the handcuffs on you. If you challenge his exousia, which is his badge, and you don't act right, he grab his dunamis, which is his gun, do you hear me?
Yeah.
That's the dynamite power to back up his authority, do you hear me?
Yeah.
This is what you guys understand about exousia, authority. You're not coming in your own name. You're coming in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Now, a police officer can show up at your door.
Uh-huh.
And he can look like Bernie Five. And he can be 120 pounds wet.
Mm-hmm.
But if he show up at your door and tell you turn around and put these cuffs on, you might say, I'm going to whoop him. You might whoop him. Do you hear me? But guess who's going to come to your door after you get through whooping him?
Yes.
all the North Little Rock fighters. You know why? Because he didn't come in his own name. He came in the name of the government. That's what comes. You don't have to be afraid, saints of God, when you tell the devil to get out your house. Because if the devil touch you, all of heaven is coming to your aid. Because God has given you exousia. God has given you authority.
Thank you, Jesus.
The angel of the Lord encamp around those who fear him.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm talking about warring angels. Do you hear me? I'm talking about archangels.
Yes.
I'm talking about mighty angels who warn the spirit.
Yes,
I'm talking about angels with flaming swords. Do you hear me? Saints of God. I'm talking about angels of breakthrough. Oh, God got angels. God showed my wife a while back of an angel sitting right there where Tonya's sitting.
Yes, Lord.
And his name was Breakthrough.
Breakthrough.
Because this is the kind of angel that shows up in the service.
My God.
And push and give the saints breakthrough. Do you hear me? All you got some reinforcement. Do you hear me? It's coming out from the glorious courts of heaven to aid and assist the people of God. God will give you exousia.
Oh, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Give you the authority.
Thank you, Lord.
The tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. Over all the power. He didn't say some of the power. He said all the power.
Sickness is
a power of the enemy. Don't you let nobody tell you that God put no sickness on you. God ain't put no sickness on you. God don't got no sickness to give you. The Bible said God is good. The Bible said God is fighting in him. There is no darkness at all. Oh, God put this sickness on me. No, baby. God ain't put no sickness on you. Jesus said the enemy come to kill, steal, and to destroy. He said, but I have come that they may have life and have it more abundantly. God ain't put no sickness on you. That's the power of the enemy. But God has given you exousia. He'll give you authority over all sickness.
My God.
He'll give you authority over all confusion. He's given you authority. Do you hear me say, God? Over all worry and fear, God has given you exousia.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Whatever power the enemy is trying to put in your life.
Oh, God.
You say, no, devil.
Yes.
That's a power of darkness.
Mm-mm-mm.
And God has given me exousia.
God.
You got to get more bold in the spirit, saints of God.
Hallelujah.
You got to open the word of God and see the promises that God has given you.
Yes.
We can't have saints of God getting whooped up and down the floor, always defeated, always depressed, always stressed out. You just heard the word of God leave outside the door. You depressed before you come back in Sunday. You know why? Because you're not walking in exousia. You're not walking in the authority of God. You just heard a good word. God told you that you don't have to be depressed, that you don't have to be stressed, that you don't have to live in fear, that you can come out of that situation. But you leave right back outside of the house of God. And you back down in the dust before Sunday comes. You know why? Because you are not walking in exousia. You're not walking in your authority. But you got to make your mind up, saints of God, that before I leave outside this house, I'm going to walk in the exousia of God.
Yes.
I'm going to walk in the authority of God.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to walk in peace, which surpasses all understanding. I'm going to walk in joy, unspeakable joy.
Yes.
I'm going to walk in the love of God. I'm going to walk in dunamis power. I'm going to walk in Holy Ghost power.
Yes.
I'm going to walk in the word of God. Do you hear me, saints of God? I got exousia.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Devil, get out in Jesus' name.
Get out in Jesus'
name. None of them will
shun.
I don't have to wrestle with you, devil. Do you hear me? I got reinforcements.
Uh-huh.
Oh, my job is to tell you to get out.
Uh-huh.
My job is to move stuff out of my house that I know that offend my God. My job is to move stuff out that when angels come in, they will feel comfortable in my house. Your atmosphere is too chaotic for angels to come in and sit in your house. Do you hear me? They get irritated when they come in your house because you got so much drugs and so much nonsense going on. But you got to create an atmosphere of worship inside your house. All I'm telling you about the peace of God. I'm telling you how me and my wife got the peace of God. We created an atmosphere of worship. We created an atmosphere of praise. We created an atmosphere of thanksgiving. We begin to live right. We begin to live holy. We begin to submit our lives unto God. And we begin to submit our lives unto God. The presence of God came in our house. All the holy angels of God begin to walk back and forth in our house. God begins to give us encounters, begins to give us visions and dreams. Do you hear me say God? All because if we understood that we had exousia.
Yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
Giving you the authority.
Giving you the authority.
But why ain't the saints walking in it?
My God.
Because they don't understand what it means. But he said, I'll give you the authority to tread upon serpents and scorpions, no water, power of the enemy, and none shall your enemies harm you.
My God.
He said, don't rejoice that the spirits are subject to you.
Mm-hmm.
But he said, rejoice that your name is written in heaven.
Yes,
he said, don't rejoice that the spirits got to do what you say. Because the demonic spirits have to do what you say.
Mm-hmm.
I know they got you thinking that you got to do what they say.
Uh-huh.
And they've been running your life all this time. But let me tell you something. You don't have to do what they say. They have to do what you say.
Yes.
Devil, get up out of here. I hear Paul telling the saints at Corinthians. He said, y'all going to court against each other?
Yes.
He said, how foolish is that?
Mm.
He said, don't you know that we should rule over angels when we get to heaven?
My
Do you hear me? Because you created the image and likeness of God. Ain't no angel telling you what to do when you get to heaven. Paul said, we're going to rule over angels.
My God.
You got authority over every demonic spirit that try to come into your house.
Yes.
Because God will give you exousia.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes. My God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now, the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Saints, make sure you submit it to him.
Yes.
When you cry out to Jesus. Because there was some sons in the book of Acts.
Yes,
my God.
Seven Jewish men.
Uh-huh.
Their father was a priest.
Yes.
They didn't have no relationship with God. I'm going to help some of y'all now. These boys didn't have no relationship with God. They hadn't submitted to Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
But they seen Paul casting out devils.
Come on.
And the Bible said God worked unusual miracles by the hands of Paul.
Mm-hmm.
That people took handkerchiefs from Paul. And when they took the handkerchiefs in their house, demons would run out the house because of the presence of God.
My God.
You say, why come they using handkerchiefs and prayer shawls?
Yes.
Because God take the foolish things of this world to confound the wise.
Yes.
God will take something so foolish like a cloth.
Yes.
And God will have us to pray over and fast over it.
Yes.
And you will take it in your house. Even people came in here that got some of this oil, couldn't sleep, went home, anointed their house, and went straight to sleep.
Uh-huh.
You know why? Because the power of God is in that oil.
Yeah.
See, your carnal mind can't understand that.
Come on.
But God take the foolishness of this world to confound the wise.
Yes.
God would take something like a prayer cloth, and God said, pray that prayer cloth, put that prayer cloth on that child, and that child get up, and that child is the fever, leave the child.
Yes.
You know why? Because of the presence of God.
Yes, Lord.
My God.
Yes,
Lord.
But these seven sons did not know Jesus. They didn't know God.
Yes.
And they seen a man that was demon possessed.
My God.
And they walked up to the man. They said, we adjure you. In the name of Jesus that they got Paul preaching. Come out of him.
Mm-hmm.
And the demon said, Jesus I know.
Uh-huh.
The demon spoke out of the man. He said, Jesus I know. He said, Paul I know. He said, but who are you?
Who are you?
And when he said, who are you? They couldn't answer him.
Yes.
And the Bible said that man jumped on seven of them and beat them out the house, out their clothes. And they fled. And everybody in the city heard of it and turned to God out of fear. Do you hear me?
Yeah.
Because what the devil want to know, what's your name?
Yes. Uh-huh.
You don't got no weight in the spirit.
Come on.
You don't got no relationship with God. The devil said, you can't tell me to get out of here.
Uh-huh.
And you smoking weed and shacky.
Jesus.
He said, I don't have to go nowhere.
My
He'll
God.
Sit right in your house. And you'll keep saying, devil, get out. And you'll just make him get more infuriated. More demons will come in and start messing with you and your family.
Yes.
They said, we run this house. Do you hear me? Because I don't know your name in the spirit.
Mm-hmm.
But when you got a relationship with God through Jesus, I'm not talking about being flawless. I'm talking about putting forth some effort, saints to God.
Yes.
Of serving God.
Yes.
When you get some weight in the spirit, the devil know your name.
Yes,
oh, my God.
And that's how come the enemy will send people to lie on you.
Yes.
People to betray you.
Oh, yes.
Once you start saying the name of Jesus, people start leaving you. People start talking about you. People start lying on you. You know why? Because your name is being heard in the spirit now.
My God.
And the enemy comes against you harder because your name is heard in the spirit.
Yes. Yes.
Never try to use the name of Jesus and you're not really submitted to him.
My God.
I'm not saying you can't cry out to him. Cry out to him.
Yes, Lord.
But don't play no games with no evil spirit.
Yes.
And you know you're not submitted to God. Because while you're trying to tell the devil to get out, the devil remind you of what you're doing.
Yes.
Oh,
and he
God.
Said, that's the reason that I have to stay here.
Yes.
Jesus.
Because of what you're doing.
What
my
you
God.
Doing.
Why can't we catch this, saints of God?
Yes.
Why ain't we listening? I see, Pastor, I'm trying to tell you the truth.
Yes.
Get stuff out your house that will invite wicked spirits in your house.
Yes.
You've been praying for 20 years and that demon ain't moved yet.
My God.
I'm telling you the reason why he ain't moved. Because you're doing things that line up with him. That's what come Jesus said when he got ready to die, before he rose again from the dead, he said, the devil is coming.
Mm-hmm.
He said, but he don't got nothing in me.
Yes.
He said, there's nothing in me for him to be connected to.
Jesus.
Do you hear me?
Yes. Yes, yes.
Acts the 4th chapter.
My God.
Yes. Brought you all the way around there just to go here.
My God.
Get through these couple of scriptures and it's over with. Being known unto you, now this is the man that was healed. Now I don't got time to go back through all that. But the man that was healed at the gate
mm-hmm.
got healed in the name of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Look what Peter told these religious leaders and scholars of the day.
Mm-hmm.
He said, be it known unto you all and to all the people of Israel that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, even by him do this man stand here before you whole. He said, this man got healed in the name of Jesus. Mm-hmm. I told you healing, your restoration, your deliverance, your turnaround, your revival is going to come through the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Your family is going to be saved through the name of Jesus. He said, in the name. What is the name? Mm-hmm. The name back in this time. See, now we got names like Billy, James, John, Marlo, Dion, One Hitter Quitter, Lil Stump Down. See, these names really don't mean nothing. Do you hear me? But if you go to the eastern parts of the world and you said a person's name, that meant their character. When you say in Jesus' name, you're telling the devil, I'm not coming in my own character, I'm coming in the character of Jesus.
Yeah.
This is the reason why I come to the enemy got to run. Yeah. If you said your character or your name, he can stay there. But when you say in the name of Jesus,
yes,
he understands that Jesus was sinless.
Yeah.
There was no sin in him, there was no gold that was found in his mouth. Do you hear me? Yeah. When you say I'm coming in Jesus' character, it don't got nothing to do with my character. I'm coming in the character of Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' character.
Yes.
God, I'm asking you for this job and his character.
Yeah.
God have not crossed every T and dotted every I. Mm-hmm. And I'm not coming in my character, I'm not bragging about my character, but I'm coming in the character of your son, Jesus.
Yes.
And what he did on the cross. In his character. Understand what you're saying when you say in the name of Jesus. Mm-hmm. Devil, get out. You saying in his character. So when the devil try to remind you what you did 3 months ago, you say it's not about my character, it's about the character of Jesus. So get out. Do you hear me, saints of God?
Yeah.
He said, in his character.
Yes.
I don't have to be moved when the devil bring up something about my past because I'm not coming in my own character. I'm coming in the character of Jesus.
Yes.
It don't matter what people bring up about me. And I knew you when you was out in the streets and you was crazy. It don't matter about that because now I'm living in the character of Jesus.
Yes.
It's no longer I who live but Christ that live in me. I don't care if it was something I did yesterday. I'm still coming in the character of Jesus.
Yes.
You have to come in his character, his name, his reputation. All Jesus got a reputation.
Yes.
Name means reputation.
Yes.
I'm coming in Jesus' reputation.
Uh-huh.
When he cast out devils, that reputation.
Yes.
When he healed the sick, that reputation.
Yes.
Do you hear me say to God? When he raised the dead, that reputation.
Yes.
When he walked on water, that reputation.
Yes, Lord.
Do you hear me?
Yes.
I'm talking about Jesus who got up out the grave.
Yes.
That same Jesus. When you say his name, they know Jesus got up out the grave.
My God.
The Bible said he went down in hell and snatched the keys of death from the enemy. He went down in hell because when they put him in the tomb the first day, demons was laughing.
Yes.
Demons was down in hell dancing.
Yes.
They said, we got him.
Oh yeah.
We got the Prince of Life.
Yeah.
They said, we killed him. We got, see, they didn't know that he was going to get up. They said, we killed him. They said, we got him. They said, we slapped him around. They said, we pulled his beard out. They said, we beat him on the back with a cat of nine tails. They said, we spit in his face, nailed his hands to the cross, his feet to the cross. They said, we stuck a spear in his side, and we took him off the cross and threw him in that tomb.
My God.
And they was rejoicing down there in hell. The second day came. They said, he said 3 days he gonna get up, but he ain't moved a muscle yet.
Come on.
Demons was rejoicing. Oh, they were getting ready to bake a cake.
Yes.
They were shouting and jumping up and down with glee.
Mm-hmm.
But on that third day,
yeah.
The tomb began to shake. Do you hear me say to God? All the rock was rolled away.
Yeah.
And Jesus got up with all power. Do you hear me? He got up with all dunamis, with all power in his hand.
Yes. My God. Yes, Lord.
The demons said, he's risen.
Uh-huh.
He went down to hell. Walked up to the enemy and snatched the keys out of his hand.
Come on.
Demons began to flee when his glory began to shine.
Uh-huh.
Do you hear me say to God? I'm talking about that same Jesus.
Yes.
Oh, I'm excited about Jesus.
Yes.
I'm excited about the leader of the valley. I'm excited about the bright and morning star. I'm excited about the lion of the tribe of Judah. I'm excited about the offspring and root of Jesse. I'm talking about Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Took the enemy's authority so he can't rule over you anymore.
My God.
Took the enemy's authority so you can stop being afraid of death. Because now you know to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord.
Yes.
That you don't have to fear death anymore. Because when I leave here, I'm just going into his presence.
Yes.
Because I submitted my life unto Jesus.
Yes.
I submitted my life unto the Father. And death is just a celebration.
Yes.
He took The fear of death from the enemy.
My God.
The name, his reputation, his fame, his authority. The name is the essence of who a person is. And when you say the name of Jesus, you're talking about in his essence.
Yes, Lord.
The enemy know when you say Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
I came in his authority.
Jesus.
He said Jesus rose his man from the dead.
Yes, Lord.
Look at verse 12. Neither is there salvation in any other. For there is no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved.
Yes.
Peter said, God has not given another name under heaven while you can be saved, saints of God.
Yes.
You can't be saved through Buddha.
No.
You can't be saved through Confucius.
Come on.
You can't be saved based on your own works, your own righteousness. You have to come through the name of Jesus.
Oh, yes.
He said, there is no other name given under heaven whereby you must be saved.
Oh, yes.
You can't walk in joy without the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I told you about the salvation package. You can't walk in the joy of God without the name of Jesus.
Oh, yes.
You've been trying to do it in your own name.
Yes.
You've been trying to use too many names.
Yes.
How many names have you been using, saints of God?
Yes.
How many names have you been clinging to through the years? Oh, I was trying a whole bunch of names. But Newport couldn't do it.
Yes.
Bumpy Face couldn't do it.
Yes.
Irk and Jerk couldn't do it. Convossier couldn't do it. The GDs couldn't do it. The vice lords and bloods and crips ain't gonna do it. Your organization ain't gonna do it.
Yeah.
Those drugs ain't gonna do it. A man ain't gonna do it. Oh, you get around a man, you get a little happy just for a little while, but that man can't fill up that empty spot. It's gonna be done through the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
You've been trying too many names.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
No, Shonda.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Oh, I tried so many names.
Hallelujah.
But when I came to Jesus, the burdens was lifted, the yokes was destroyed. I got joy down inside my spirit.
Yes.
I never laughed that much.
Yes.
The people used to tell me at the job, man, you hire some? Because I'm so joyful about Jesus.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
And I used to laugh because I know,
yes, Lord.
Man, I can knock your teeth out your mouth right now if I want to.
Yes.
I can break your jaw in three different places and you don't even know that. You talking to a man who have done a whole lot of dirt. And you talking crazy to me, but I'm over filled with joy because of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
It used to tickle me when people talk crazy. I said, I know what I can do to this man.
Yes, Lord.
But because of Jesus.
Because of Jesus.
Some people need to be happy that you're serving Jesus.
Yes.
Do you hear me? Because of Jesus, I had joy and still got that joy.
Yes.
That gladness. Do you hear me? It comes through Jesus, saints.
Yes.
Stop trying to use other names. What name are you using? What name have you been trying to use?
Hallelujah,
to come out your situation. It's going to be done in the name of Jesus.
Name of
that
Jesus.
Wonderful name
yes.
of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Saints, submit yourself to him.
Yes, Lord.
I tried him.
Yes.
I tried him. And I found out he's a deliverer.
Yes.
Some of you need to be careful about thinking about going back out into that world.
Hallelujah.
Because you're going to get caught up in it.
Oh, my God.
Don't you let nobody put no stuff in your ear.
Yeah, no, that's
right. Yeah. God, get ready to bless you. And you thinking about going back, you better stay where you at.
Yes, Lord.
And you're going to get trapped in it.
Oh, yes.
You finished. Tanya, come back up one more time. I want to pray with you one more time. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Because I want God to touch you again.